Welcome to the Investing Podcast, presented by Tusk Media. This is Outsider Trading, an audio and video deep dive into the people, places, and things that we find most interesting in the market.
Hey everybody, welcome back to the Investing Podcast. We're covering earnings reports this week. In this video, we have our senior equity analyst, Ben Nye, discussing JP Morgan. Thanks for joining us.
Okay, well today, we're going to be talking about a variety of earnings reports. JP Morgan is kind of the king of the banks right now. Jamie Dimon is back on top as the king of the American banking industry. It's funny, you know, think back a few years ago when you're talking about JP Morgan and you're talking about a company that just lost billions of dollars, that which was, quote, a tempest in a teapot. That's what Jamie Dimon said, and it was a total train wreck. I mean, it was a disaster for them at the time, both the public relations and the actual loss. And in fact, I would argue that the loss from that was probably more than what Wells Fargo was going through in its account scandal. Having said that, Jamie Dimon, you know, with all his bravado and all his arrogance, came out and basically ring-fenced the issue, made it out to be very small. And, you know, in the context of a large entity like Jamie Dimon, like JP Morgan, and with how well capitalized the company is, yeah, maybe it was a relatively small issue. Having said that, JP Morgan now is the king on the street. Earnings per share of $2.37. Estimate was $2.28. They beat on trading revenue. Trading revenue was huge. Really, across the banks, across the big banks, the JP Morgans and Bank of America's, Goldman Sachs's, equity and sales trading. You know, with increased volatility, these banks do far, far better. And that's both on the equity side and the fixed income side. Fixed income revenue beat, currency revenue beat. Revenue overall came in at $28.5 million. The estimate was $27.7 million. Net interest margin performed well. Credit quality was strong. I mean, it's just kind of one of those quarters that hit on every box. They know how to run the conference call, too. There's just no drama when you're talking about JP Morgan. Jamie Dimon wasn't even on the conference call this quarter. He handed that off to his CFO, Marianne Lake. And, you know, she's just ticks the boxes. And if someone asks a dumb question, she demurs and doesn't answer it and then moves on. And usually these analysts are so granular that that's the best way to go about it. They'll try to find one ratio that may be a little bit out of whack. And there's always going to be one ratio that's out of whack. And Wells Fargo, you know, they'll try to be earnest and adjust and explain. And they just kind of get all lost in their bowl of soup. And JP Morgan just says, "Here, here's the steak. Eat it. It's medium. It's how you like it. It's how everyone should like it. If you want it well done, go somewhere else, because we're giving it to you the way you need it." So that's how JP Morgan runs its calls. Strong quarter. Credit cards doing really well. Revenue take on the card was 11.6%, far better than expected. And on the deposit side, they're not having to pay much yet. They're just not paying much at all, even though interest rates are going up. So that's a huge boost to them, because they're only paying 25 basis points or whatever you have on the deposits. And they say, you know, we have a great brand. People want to bank with us. So good quarter from JP Morgan. It is rightly seen as the best operator right now. I think that banks generally are, you know, you revert to the mean in banking. There isn't a huge benefit to one business over another over an extended period of time, over extended managers. So I do think that you'll see some reversion to the mean. But right now, JP Morgan's the king of the hill.
Tusk Media is a subsidiary of Narwhal Capital Management. Ratings and reviews of Tusk Media content are not to be construed as endorsements of opinions, analysis, or services offered by Tusk or its parent company. The opinions and predictions shared here are our professional beliefs at the time of publication. We are not under duress from any of the corporate entities mentioned. This is not a solicitation to take any particular action. Although we are investment advisors, this information should not be considered investment, legal, or tax advice. We strive to be as impartial, insightful, and accurate as possible. We base our opinions, analysis, and calculations on information we believe to be reliable, but we cannot guarantee its accuracy. We can, however, guarantee that our opinions will sometimes be flat out wrong due to a variety of factors. Employees and clients of Narwhal Capital Management may or may not hold positions in the securities detailed and may or may not hold these positions in the future. A full list of all securities purchased, sold, or held during the 12 months preceding the date of this publication can be provided upon request. Unless otherwise noted, all data accessed via MarketWatch or the Bloomberg Terminal. Past performance does not guarantee future results. A copy of Narwhal's Form ADV is available at the SEC's website, www.advisorinfo.sec.gov, or from Narwhal upon written request.